Today, discuss the zodiac of Libra as we answer now this important zodiac in Hebrew, the month of Tishrei, the month of Rosh Hashanah, Yom Kippur, Day of Atonement coming soon. Then we have Sukkot, Simchat Torah, lots of festivals, important one in this months. So let us see ideas which I wrote in my book about the zodiac. You can get it in glazersonbooks.com, also Amazon. And in this book, I bring many sources about this month, this zodiac, taken from my Kabbalistic book. Main one is the Book of Formation, related to Abraham. This is a book which was really the basis of creation. From this book, one can created man. It's a story of the Maharal who created the man using this book of creation. So let us start now seeing what this book telling us about this month. So if you followed my lectures on zodiacs, astrology and Jewish life, so every time I brought the zodiac, I brought the letter, Hebrew letter with which it was created. As you remember, I mentioned that the letters of the alphabet, 22 of them, were used for creating the elements, with the letter Aleph, Mem, Shin, and the planets that we can see with our eyes, which is Jupiter, Mars, then the Sun, Mercury, Venus, Moon, Luna. So those are planets which were created with Hebrew letters which have dots in them, like you have the letter bet. You can, if there is a dot inside, you say bet. If it's not dot, you say vet. So the idea is that those planets really had great impact on the world, and therefore they were created with seven letters, which in Hebrew are bigger than Kaporet, and those. Well, as we said, the planets. So after using three for the elements and using seven for the planets, we remained with 12 ordinary letters. So then we start with the letter Hey, because the letter Aleph we use for the air, create the air. Bet we use creating Saturn, Gimel created Jupiter, Dalet Mars. Definitely there is a reason why those letters for those planets in my book above the zodiac, I explained exactly why. So the letter, a single letter, is a Hey. So this letter was a letter with which the month of Nisan, Aries, was created. Then next month, which is Taurus, Iyar, letter Vav, Gemini, this is Sivan, with the letter Zayin. Then month Cancer, Tammuz, with Chet, Leo, with Tet, Virgo, with Yud, and Tishrei, this month, with the letter Lamed. And there is a reason for it. We see just now why the Lamed is the letter of this month, of Tishrei, of the zodiac of Libra. Libra starts with L also, Libra. But there is very deep ideas behind, which is really very important to understand, because this is which makes the difference with secular, mundane astrology and Jewish man. So Lamed, the letter Lamed in Hebrew, if you know a little bit of alphabet, the letter Lamed is the highest from all the letters. Yeah, if you see the letter Lamed comparing to the others is the highest one. It is called the king of the letters. Lamed, right? No, definitely fits very much this zodiac, this month, because in this month we envy makes God a king. Yeah, dedicate him, make him as a king, as a melech. All the prayers of Rosh Hashanah are on melech, mloch al kol ha'olam, rule all over the world. So this is the time of kingdom of God. Said definitely Yom Kippur, the Day of Atonement also. Lots of prayers there clearly emphasize God, you are the king of the universe. So Lamed is the king of the letters, but he's much more behind. The gematria of Lamed is 30. And our rabbis tell us how many kinyanim, how many ways, means is necessary to get kingdom. So you can also how many ways you get the Torah. So the Torah is 48. Interesting, 48 is got the numerical value of the letter Moach, brain. Lamed, kingdom, is 30. And 30 is the number of ways to get kingdom. Definitely it's for the king. To keep his kingdom going, we should keep these 30 days, Lamed. So, kingdom and Lamed goes together with this month. Then, there is another meaning to the letter Lamed. Like in Hebrew, every letter has a meaning. Not like English, we say A, B, C, E, D, E. In English, Aleph, learning means a bet, is buy, is a house. Gimel is granting, Dalet, poverty. There is meaning to each letter in Hebrew. And this is the most important understanding about the creation. If you know the meaning of the letters, you know with which things were created, elements and so on, you'll understand the meaning of it. With the stars also. So, Lamed means learning. This is the root of the Hebrew Lamed, Limud, Lamed. Limed, Talmud, Lamed. No, Lelamed, Lilmod. So, Lamed is the root of learning. As you learn yourself, you teach others. And learning is very important, definitely. The purpose of the creation is to learn, to understand. Purpose of creation, to learn Torah. So, Lamed means learning. So, shows that this zodiac of Libra requires a lot of learning, definitely. When you are really in the days of Or, Rosh Hashanah, Yom Kippur, and to learn a lot about it, to learn about creation, to learn about the purpose of creation. Lots of learning is acquired, should be acquired, really, in this month. So the letter Lamed represents it. Another interesting idea behind the Lamed, we saw that it represents God, the king of the universe. But there is a way to see in the Lamed the kingdom of God. Every letter in Hebrew, most of the letters, one can say, is combined of few letters. Yeah, like if you take the Aleph, in Hebrew you can see clearly you have the middle line, like the Hebrew letter Vav, 6, and on top you have the shape of Yud, and on the bottom, Yud is 10. To Together 26, now the letter Aleph, the first one, represents God, the beginning of the world. So Aleph also aloof, the English word aloof, very likely taken from Hebrew, aloof, because aloof in Hebrew means a teacher, an important person, but the word Aleph is teaching, yeah. Then, what you see in the Lamed, which combination, so you will see, and this how it is written in the Sefer Torah, in the scroll of Torah. On top you have the letter Vav, the high part, and this letter Vav is on top of Kaf, of the letter Kaf. And this makes together the Hebrew letters Kaf and Vav. Kaf and Vav, 26. 26 is the number of God, Yud, K, Vav, K, Yud, 10, A, 5, Vav, 6, and A. So 26, in English, by the way, also, the English word God, G-O-D, also, brings you to 26. G, the 7th, or the 15th, Dalet, D, the 4th, the card. So God is also God in English. Yeah, God is good, it's why. It's called in Hebrew, God is Tov, Tov, Hashem Lakol. The English took the God because he is good. But you have to be in good ways to get the goodness of God. So, interesting. Now, in Hebrew, there is a reason for the 26, because 26 is double 13. As the Jews are not afraid of the 13, opposite. Now we have days of mercy, 13 days of mercy. Then, what is interesting is that 26 is 13 and 13. 13 has gematria, numerical value of Echad, which is one, unity. Aleph is one, Chet is eight, Dal is four, and Ahava. Ahava also 13, Aleph one, A five, Bet 2 and A5, 13 and 13, which is unity and love. This is exactly what God is. This is why we say, Shema Yisrael, Hashem Elokeinu, Hashem Echad, O Israel, listen, God is one, Echad, Ve'avta, and immediately after what comes Ve'avta, and you should love him. So interesting, unity and love. So in Hebrew, really, 26 is definitely meaning, and also 2 and 6 is 8, representing God who is above nature. Nature is basic, is number 7. Is the mean. This is really what nature is connected with 7, everything 7, 7 days. So, planets which affect, that one can see, affect strongly the world. And then, also 7 musical notes, lot of 7. So, this is really what 26 represents God, as we said in the miracle also, in a small gematria, 8, which is 8, representing also above nature. In fact, the shape of the 8, people don't know, but it comes for Pythagoras, yeah? The number, yeah, the book of numbers. In fact, it is known that he learned a lot for the Jewish prophet, yeah, Hezkel. So lots of ideas that he had, he took from Judaism, really. So, Lamed. So Lamed, learning, time of learning, and Lamed, kingdom, we should accept the yoke of God, it means the kingdom of God. And this is exactly what are those festivals now. So this is really the letter, Lamed, with which this zodiac was formed. And as I brought you, by means of the letter Lamed, the tallest of all the Hebrew letters, the astrological sign of this month is scale, Libra. Now what is interesting in the shape of the letter Lamed, we spoke that is contained of God, 26, Kaf and Vav. But it's very interesting that's more about this letter, and the idea is in the shape of the letter Lamed. Lamed is similar to the form of the balance scales. You know, at that time, they did not have what we have today. So if you remember, there's such a two like place, you know, and it was on top something which was holding them, right? So this is a real scales, you know, to place, what you call it, yeah? And this shape of the Lamed, he was holding these two. This is the month. This is why this month is called Libra. And Libra is the scale. And also interesting to point out that if you go into the meaning of the zodiac, you see to understand, you understand Judaism, because definitely when you speak about Libra in this month, this is a time that our deeds are on the scales, yeah? The right one, good ones, left one, not good ones. So the Lamed, the shape of the Lamed, remind us the scale, and definitely most important is that this is a time that men's deeds are weighed upon scales. So this is Libra. And this is the letter Lamed again, connected with the scales. Now every month also have a tribe. Yeah? There are 12 tribes. Judah, no, all of them, Issachar, Zbun. So each month, Zodiac has a tribe, and also is connected with it. It is also an interesting explanation, you can see in my book, what is the connection. So the tribe of the month of Tishrei is Ephraim. You know who is Ephraim? Ephraim is the son of Joseph. Now also something very, very important besides tribes, discuss about the connection, but also every month have combination of God letters. It means that there are four letters, Yud, A, Vav, and A, Yud, Ke, Vav, Ke. And every month is different combination. Yeah, like the known one is Yismechu HaShamayim V'Tagel HaAretz. This is Eris, Nisan. This is a normal one, can say the right way. Yud, Ke, Vav, Ke. Yismechu HaShamayim, this is abbreviation. Heaven will be happy with Tagel HaAretz, and the earth will be happy. So Yud Ke Vav Ke will be happy when you follow God's ways, definitely follow the Torah. Now the others has different combination. Some start with Vav Ke Yud Ke, Ke Yud Vav Ke, different, each one connected. Now the connection of these months with the combination of letters of divine name is a Yud Vav Ke Yud Ke. Now, it means really it is interesting. It is also has a meaning in Hebrew, V'aya, and it will be. Lots of good prophecies about the future is starting in the Bible, V'aya. V'aya Be'achrit HaYamim will be in the end of days. V'aya Be'yom Ahu will be. So V'aya also in its meaning are the letters of God, right? Okay. The same letters of God, Yud Ke Vav Ke. Why? V'aya, and it will be. This is exactly with this month that you have Rosh Hashanah, the beginning of the world. Alright, so V'aya have to do with this month. The essential nature of this month is symbolized in the image of men. Connection with men and women, because this is a month, you know, that we come close to God. Yeah, this is all the idea of Rosh Hashanah, Yom Kippur, the 10 days, those are days when God is very close to us, to the Jewish people. And it is known that God and Israel are like a bride and Chatan Bekala, yeah, a bride In a chosen chatan. So this is so interesting that because of this, the character, like every man says, the character is relation between man and woman, husband and wife, because this is exactly what are the connection with God. Now, what's more, it is known that every month really has a meaning. Yeah, in fact, it is in Aramaic, but it's very, very close to Hebrew. So therefore, this month is called Tishrei. Yeah, so the name of the month Tishrei indicates that it is the beginning of a new year, for it contains the same letters as the word Bereshit, in the beginning. In the Hebrew, Tishrei is basically like Reshit, yeah, beginning. And this also goes with the meaning of the word and the fact that the letters of the name Tishrei proceed in the opposite way of the natural order of the alphabet. The first letter, then. Now, in fact, this we have to explain to you, because, you know, in the Hebrew, the last letters are, the last letter is Taf, before is Shin, before is Reish. And Yud represent really the Neshama, the Yehudi. The month of Nisan, for example, is called in the Torah Aviv. Aviv is Aleph Bet Yud, going from down to up. So on Tishrei we go from up to down. Taf, then comes Shin. Taf is 400, the last letter, then comes Shin, 300, then comes Reish, 200, and then comes the Yud. So what is the idea? So the idea goes with the time, because Nisan, Aviv, is the time of everything is flourishing, blooming, right? And this is time of loving kindness, Pesach, Passover. But Tishrei is the time of returning to the source, doing Shuvah. This is why Shuvah also starts Taf Shin. Yeah, also going backward, you go backward to the right way, to the you, to the spiritual point of view. So it is interesting also how the name of the month tells you what is the meaning of the month. This is the month that we have to return, to go back to the beginning, to do Shuvah. What is Shuvah? Returning. Lashuv. Shuvu elai v'ashuvu elachem. So returning is the letter Taf Shin. Then also, it is very interesting that there is a meaning to the word Tishrei. So in Aramaic, the meaning of the Aramaic word Tishrei is atonement, Sharileh, yeah? Sharileh, Kosh Baruch Hu like, forgive you. This is the meaning in Aramaic. The atonement of the deeds of the past enables a person to turn over a new leaf in his life and begin afresh. Now this is the idea, as I told you, that the Tishrei bring you from the back, like Taf Shin Resh, to the Yud. Yud represent beginning. It's beginning, the letter Yud also, because it's very, what is Yud? You know, the shape of the Yud is like a small point. Every letter that you start writing, you start with a Yud, right? So this is the idea of this month, to bring you back to the Yud, to the beginning, to start a new leaf in your life. By the way, this is Virgo. If you followed my lecture on Virgo, Virgo was created with the letter Yud. But Yud, Virgo, Elul, is the time of Tshuva, to prepare you for Rosh Hashanah. So definitely the month of Elul of Virgo is to do with the letter Yud. Start to get out of all the wrong things that you did, cut it, and start with the original points. Means this neshama, the yud, then work on yourself and bring it to the letters of Lamed, to Tishrei, big letters, you know, from the small letter to the biggest. So letter yud, therefore, Tishrei is Tashar yud, come back to yud, and Aviv, God helps you to come to the yud. It is very interesting that in Hebrew there is a famous sentence which indicates to Elul, which is Anile Dodi. This is a verse from Song of Song. Anile Dodi, I to my beloved and my beloved to me. It means I start working on myself to come near to my beloved God. And then, if you are really working on yourself, it's like to come to God, praying and all what you need, then God will come to you. Now, in fact, in Nisan, there is another verse, also for Song of Song, which says, Dodi li v'ani lo. My beloved is to me, and I am to you. Why? Because Nisan, Passover, this month of spring, is a month when God comes first back to us, but he comes to us, and we come back to him. So it's amazing, two verses in Shir HaShirim. Ani le dodi ve dodi li, I to my beloved, beloved to me. This is this man Tishrei, time of din, of judgment. You have to work on yourself to come to God. On Nisan, dodi li ve ani lo. On Nisan, my beloved is near to me, yeah, and I have to make use of it and to come near to him. So it's interesting. All fits with the idea of this man, of this zodiac. Now, when we go more into this, there is essential nature of this month, which is mating, interesting, yeah, which I mean mating. It means the connection between God and the Jewish people. So intimate relationship between husband and wife symbolizes the fact that during this month, the unifying relationship between God and the Jewish people was formed, as I told you before. This is especially revealed on Yom Kippur, the 10th day of the month, Tishrei, when the two tablets containing the 10 commandments were given to us. This may be linked to a wedding gift, for just as a man acquires a wife by giving to her a symbolic gift, and she understands that by accepting it, she is consenting to marry him, so too, with the giving of the 10 commandments, which was in Yom Kippur, we know the 10 commandments were given in Yom Kippur. This was the second time we received the commandments. And thus, this was the second marriage. The first marriage upon receiving the first set of tables in Shavuos, 50 days after Passover, was annulled, as we know the story, because Jews were serving the golden calf. And then, because of the sin of the golden calf, we lost the first tablets. Upon accepting the commandments, we became a nation of priests, as is written, Mamlechet Kohanim, and thus, really, the famous expression, chosen nation. This was the chosen nation at that time, that the Holy One, blessed be He, thereby we became the head of all nations. Okay. This was written, literally what God said to the Jewish people. You are like priests. Mamlechet Kohanim, Begoy Kadosh, you are like priests. Your goal in life is to teach the Goyim to be light to the world. But this is only when we keep the Torah. So, it is interesting to see what the secular astrology says about this sign, about the zodiac. So according to the science of astrology, people born under the sign of Libra are especially blessed by harmonious and pleasurable feeling. Yeah, people who are really pleasurable people, yeah, beloved by people. In matters communal relationships, these blessings are refined and intensified by the opening of the spirit in relation between man and God, following the ways of Torah. So, interesting how things which are really in secular are much limited comparing to what really they are in Judaism, like men and God and men and women. Now the scales, which is Libra, which is the astrological symbol of this month, signifies the Day of Judgment that opens this month, which is Rosh Hashanah, this is, yeah, and dictate a period of soul searching. This is what I said, really, because learning, what you have to learn, you have to really make souls. This is really, in Hebrew you call it Cheshbon Nefesh, yeah? You have to make soul searching, weighing the deeds of the past year. This is really our work, to understand what one should do, what the Torah requires from us, and then to give account whether we did it properly. Now it is interesting what astrology assigns to a person born under the sign of Libra, the nature of the being interested in many areas of endeavor and thus have difficulty with decision making. Interesting. They say the person of this think too much and difficult for him to decide. The commandments of the Torah facilitates one's ability to focus and organize in the spirit of holiness the complicated and confused energies of one's secular activities. So it means a man of Libra have a little bit difficult to decide, you know, think maybe this is good, this is better, maybe this one. So, okay, this is what happened to a man who don't have Torah, you know. The Torah tells you exactly what is the right way, what you should do, what you should not do. So, very interesting, as I said, to compare the secular, the mundane, to the holy. Now, another, as I told you in the beginning, that elements were created with letters, because every month have element. It means